All right, so the new Apple Card is out, and you may have heard about some of the cool features that it has, like text-based customer support, that there are no fees, that you get rewards immediately, and real simple sign-up process and all these things. You know, just in typical Apple fashion, they make it really enticing and really great. But there are some things you need to be aware of before you get this card and some reasons that you may not want this card, and that's what we're gonna go over now. So number one, you can actually do a good bit better than the cashback rewards that Apple is offering, and we'll talk about some specifics of cards you can consider at the end of this video. But first off, Apple is offering 1% cashback with their regular titanium card, and then 2% if you use Apple Pay on any other regular products, and then 3% on Apple products, but I don't even count that because that's such a small amount. Now, the 2% cashback is actually pretty good, but it's still limited for most of us because there's still a lot of places that don't accept Apple Pay. And so then if they don't accept Apple Pay, then you need to use the titanium Apple card that they give you, and then you're only getting 1% cashback. Now, 1.5% seems to be kind of the industry standard for cashback cards, and some even pay more than that. And so that 0.5% might not seem like a lot, but that really can add up to a whole lot of money. And that just might be a reason why you want to avoid this card and get a different card instead. Number two is that the Apple card, the titanium Apple card, is actually really delicate. And this is kind of hilarious, but there are reports of wallets discoloring the card. And on top of that, Apple actually warns you themselves not to put the card in contact with any other cards because it might scratch it. All right, number three is that you are an Android user and you want to remain that way. And according to Apple's website, you need to own a compatible iPhone just to apply for the card. Now, maybe they'll open that up a little bit wider at some point, but that's what they're saying at this point. All right, number four is that this card does not provide any travel insurance. Now, you may not know this, but this is kind of a standard for most credit cards. Most credit cards have some form of travel insurance built in, and it's just one of those perks that a lot of us won't need very often, but it's really nice to know that it's there if you do need it. And number five is that there's no car insurance waiver protection for car rentals. This is another perk that a lot of credit cards have built in, to where if you're renting a car and you use that credit card to do the rental, you can decline the car insurance coverage because the credit card is going to cover you. And so again, check your credit card to see if this is a feature and a perk that you have available to you, and you can save a little bit of money each time you are renting a car. Number six, there's no price protection built into the card. Now, the card that I use, which I'll talk about in just a minute here, has price protection built in. So if I buy something and the price is lowered, I can call the credit card company and they will go ahead and refund me the difference. And that is a pretty cool perk. And number seven is that the Apple Card does not provide an extended warranty service like a lot of credit cards do as well. And this is another perk that can really come in handy. So many products have like a 1-year warranty on the product, but if you buy it on certain credit cards, they will extend that warranty for you automatically. And so if something goes wrong after a year and a half or 2 years, in many cases, you can still get a replacement for that product. So the point of this video isn't to convince you not to get the Apple Card. There's a lot of different things that they're doing that I'm actually really excited about. And I think they've created a great product, but it is to let you know that just like most Apple products, there are actually better ones out there. They just have done a really good job with marketing and design and creating a really pretty package. So I think this begs the question, what card should you get instead? And ultimately it's gonna depend on a variety of factors, like what types of reward you want, your credit score, whether or not you're gonna be carrying a balance on it, which you shouldn't be. And the Chase Freedom Unlimited card is kind of the card to beat. It's the one that kind of does all the seven of the things that we just said that the Apple Card doesn't. It has 4.8 stars over like 9,000 plus reviews from customers, and it has no annual fee, and it actually pays 1.5% cash back on everything. But be warned, it is definitely not as pretty as the Apple Card. But if that doesn't matter to you too much and you'd rather have a little bit more money in your pocket and some of these other perks, then this might be a card to check out. I actually did a video review about this card a few months back when I signed up for it, and I'll have that linked up so you can check that out. Or you can read more about the card over at seedtime.com/freedom if you want to find out more about it. All right, so now I want to hear from you. Let me know, are you going to get this Apple Card? Why or why not? Let me know down in the comments. Let me know if you got a better alternative. Let me know about it. I want to hear it. And that's all for today. Be blessed, be a blessing, and I'll see you next time.